In today's video, we will be looking at the role of a pastor, so stay tuned. My name is Zeke Matthew, and Anime C is for you who like original movies and series, as well as clean anime and manga reviews. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. If you have not seen the other parts in the series, I highly recommend watch those before you watch this one in the video card above. And for those returning, I'm not saying that all pastors are like this or all churches are like this. I'm just trying to get rid of the mindset that we created the church to be. In the Bible, we have books, and in each book are chapters. And within each chapter, there are verses, and each verse is 1 through 30 or 1 through 50. They're all numbered. So when we start quoting scriptures, look for the chapter, the book name, and the verse that I am quoting so you can follow along in your own translation. So in the seven things that make up the American church, we learned that the pastor is someone who guides us through the Bible as well as preaches and teaches from it. So, what's wrong with this picture? Well, simply, I can't find any biblical scripture to back this up in the New Testament, and I've tried. So, question is, what is the role of a pastor? You see these pastors on stages preaching and teaching from the Bible, but is it biblically true? Let's look at the scriptures. All the scripture I am quoting comes from the Voice Bible Translation. And if you want to look at these verses, I will put a link in the description below so that you can see where the verses come from. Our first scripture is 1 Corinthians 4:8. Now let's see if I have it straight. You suppose that you already have all you need. You already are rich and prosperous, and without us, you've already begun to reign like kings. To be honest, I wish you did reign so that we could reign with you. Our second scripture is 1 Corinthians 4:18. But the reality is, some of you have put yourself on pedestals and live like you are high above the rest. It's as if you assumed I would not return to confront your misguided pride. Now, let's dive deep into this. Look at the word pedestal in this scripture. A definition is a position in which someone is greatly or uncritically admired. So basically, what pastors have done is they have put themselves on a stage to be admired by the people. And this is not biblically true in the scriptures. They're not meant to be on these pedestals. They're meant to be down with the crowd. A good example in the church is if I go on stage, all of a sudden I become more important. And all you do is look up to me instead of God. Then you have put me on a pedestal, or in this situation, an idol before you to get the words from me and not from God. And this is what's happened with pastors in the church. They have become idols or kings on these pedestals we've put them on. Remember, pastors are no different than me and you. They may be more gifted in certain areas, but just remember, they are just like us. Our next scripture is James 1, verse 26. Through 27. If you put yourself on a pedestal thinking you have become a role model in all things religious, but you can't control your mouth, then think again. Your mouth exposes your heart, and your religion is useless. Real true religion from God the Father's perspective is about caring for the orphans and widows who suffer needlessly and resisting the evil influence of the world. You see, the pastor role model is not the same as the scriptures tell us. They're not supposed to be on pedestals or, in this sense, stages preaching and teaching to us. The Bible clearly speaks against this. Our next scripture is 1 Timothy 3, 1 through 2. Here's another statement you may trust. If anyone is seeking a position as an overseer in the church, he desires an honorable and important work. Here's the qualifications to look for in an overseer: a spotless reputation, the husband of one wife, sober-minded, sensible, respectable, welcoming to strangers, allowing them into his home, and gifted to teach. Now, I know what you're saying. It says gifted to teach. What makes this so different? I want you to look at the word overseer. The definition of an overseer is someone whose job is to watch something in order to check that it works in the way it should. As you see, an overseer is not someone on stage or a king on stage teaching and preaching. He is someone who oversees the congregation and helps them along the way. So an overseer sees over the congregation. He helps them along the way. But he's interactive with the congregation. He's not just one person on stage. He interacts. He is maybe more mature in the faith to help guide new believers in the faith. But he's not there to be a people pleaser. He's just to help you along the way. Another scripture pastors like to quote is Isaiah 40, verse 11. He will feed his fold like a shepherd. He will gather together his lambs, the weak and the wobbly ones, into his arms. He will carry them close to his bosom and tenderly lead like a shepherd the mother of her lambs. So what is a pastor then if we have proven what he is not? Well, if you follow what a pastor says he is a shepherd. A lot of pastors refer to them in the congregation that they're feeding the flock, that they're guiding the flock. But is this true? Let's look at the definition. The definition of a shepherd is a person who herds, tends, and guards sheep. A person who protects, guides, or watches over other people. As you see, a shepherd in our terms would be a caregiver to the flock, helping every sheep in their needs and guarding them from danger. As you see, that is the role of a pastor. He's a caregiver in the congregation, helping every member in his church with their needs. I will give you a perfect example. My friend's mom, who works in a hospital, has a pastoral heart, caring for one another and spreading the gospel and caring for one another. I'm going to leave you with one last scripture, and that is Ephesians 6, verse 6. Don't put on a show just because you are looking as if you were a people pleaser, but as a slave of the anointed, do the will of God from your heart. I want you to look at the word people pleaser and ask yourself, is a pastor today, as we see them, a people pleaser on stage, on pedestals? Or are they helping people and everyone's needs? Are they helping the congregation? So I hope this answers questions on what the role of a pastor in a church is. Put in the comments below on what you think the role of a pastor is. And in the next video, we will be looking at praise and worship. And never forget, animacy is for you. Thank you.